The Masters
Welcome to another beautiful episode of the Master's Playground. I am your host, Chrissy Stereo. Hi, loves. Yes, happy Thursday. Oh, right on. Oh, my God. Okay, so the changes are officially taking effect. I loved speaking in code. Right on. All right, in tonight's episode, we are looking at comparing, competing, and complaining. I am. Yes. We're going to play amazing music along the way. And if you guys are feeling it, feel free to go ahead and call 1-800-893-9562 for a free Kabbalah Tarot reading. One question per caller, please. All right. So before we get started, let me take a moment to tune in. As you tune in to me and I to you, we take a moment to tune in together and tune into our higher self. Magic. Placing our hands in prayer position in front of our heart chakras. Take a breath in. Exhale. And on the next breath, we'll begin. Om Namo Gurudev. Everything is getting faster. The work that we have to do has to happen at a faster rate now. This is the year of the ram, the goat, the sheep. This is the year that we are to truly not only know, but truly nurture ourselves. And so with that, that means a lot of change, which is nothing more than another word for healing. We're going to be triggered in so many different ways. Asked to let go of even that. And depending on what you have set your mind upon, depending on how much your heart is involved, will dictate just how far you can get in the work. How the work will behoove you. So in tonight's episode, comparing, competing, and complaining, I am. Do you ever find yourself comparing your own self to someone else? Subconsciously or even consciously competing with someone else? What about complaining? How much time, effort, in action is placed into the act of competing? Yogi Bhajan has highlighted that a woman has three enemies: comparing, competing, and complaining. I want to start off with a song before we get into the wisdom. Enjoy. Back home. Yes, loves. That was beautiful, wasn't it? Okay, so who was that? Yes, Zelia Day covering Seven Nation Army. All right, so in this episode, we are embracing those moments of complaining, comparing, or comparing, competing, and complaining. You know, and I want to begin by placing a very large, or placing our focus on something. Women. Yogi Bhajan has highlighted that the three enemies that a woman has are those aspects, those expressions, those values. Right? Because obviously, it's a value if you keep incorporating it into, you know, if one keeps incorporating it into our lives, it becomes some sort of value system that we function in. Now, it's important for men to also pay attention to this, but let's start with a female. You know, for women, it is commonplace, especially during the Piscean age, to have engaged in the world by running a lot of male energy. Assertiveness. Running with the boys. So that one could be understood, one could be embraced as an equal, and even breaking through in various creative ways into leadership roles. And with that, women have had to really dig in and compete. Competing with men. And that has been a solar point of view. But the fact is, when a female who acts male is out of her own divinity, that's what happens to the female energy. Her own radiance. There are two types of women. A woman who is either one with the spirit of the woman, or a woman in the body of a woman. If you are a woman in the body of a woman, then you are not authentic. You can fall apart in a couple of minutes, but once you have the spirit of a woman in you, nothing can touch you. The authentic power of a woman is that when she embodies being a woman, she is the universe. However, with this comes great responsibility. We must stop mistaking our sexuality as our power. We must understand what the word grace means, for it is the foundation to all that we hold. It is our roots, our power, and our greatest gift. Now, the principle for women is to find their grace, their dignity, and their divinity. Being the creators of humanity, we hold the same power as the divine. In yogic philosophy, God dwells in all things. However, women have the power to create the divine by carrying it in their womb and giving birth to it. It is the cycle that only women experience. Once women embrace and embody, truly embody grace, the world will melt at your feet. However, to do this, we need to know ourselves. We need to understand that our power is our soft hearts. It gives us the ability to see the unseen through our intuition. You know, Yogi Bhajan often has highlighted that a woman's intuition is 16 times greater than that of a man's. So where do men fit in all of this, right? For men, well, it's important for you to know, what's important for you to know is to stay steady and support women. For she is great. She is infinite. She is the divine. So with that, another song, shall we?
Yes.
Enjoy tonight's ride, man. It's going to be really groovy. Enjoy. Thank you.
there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Well, your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. And she tied you to her kitchen chair. And she broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew. Baby, I've been here before. I've seen this room and I've walked this floor. You know, I used to live alone before I knew you. And I've seen your flag on the marble arch. And love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. Hallelujah. There was a time when you let me know what's really going on below, but now you never show that to me, do you? But remember when I moved in you and the holy dove was moving too, and every breath we drew is hallelujah, hallelujah. Maybe there is a God above, but all I've ever learned from love was how to shoot somebody who outdrew you. And it's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken heart.
sings. Yes, Jeff Buckley. Hallelujah. Okay. So in this episode, we've been looking at how incredible it is to be a woman. And with that, there's an emphasis that's had in yogic tradition that the female is the divine, birthing the divine. However, there's responsibility to maintain that frequency, to embody the godliness that is the choice of being in this world, in this life, as a woman. However, there's been an emphasis placed on the three enemies that a woman could ever have: competing, complaining, comparing. So I invite everyone to ask themselves, where am I comparing myself to someone else? Where am I complaining in my life? Where am I competing? It's all false. It's not real. Comparing. According to Webster's Dictionary, it is an estimate, measure, or note to the similarity or dissimilarity between. It is to have a specified relationship with another thing or person in terms of nature or quality. Now, why is this being highlighted? When a woman who is the divine chooses to focus on anything outside of her own divinity and grace, especially by comparing herself to another, it's compensation. One begins to operate against their own psyche, their authenticity, which in turn impacts your manifestation abilities. When lost in comparing oneself, we lose the power of our own infinity. Do you look at the efforts of another and compare yourself to them? Notice how the ego engages, how it makes actions that are taken from this ego state express itself. The compensation. So instead of comparing, holding on to the details of they are doing this or that, how about saying, I am enough? How about seeing the God in all? Enjoy. In this episode, we are talking about how incredibly divine a female is. Hold up. I got excited. I forgot to hit stop. Excuse me. The divinity of a female. When one does the work to maintain the grace, the universe is hers because she is the universe. Yeah. So in this episode, we're discussing the three enemies to a female. Comparing, competing, complaining. And I keep shuffling it because they're all interchangeable. You know, they're all the same, but not really. So before this particular song, we ended up talking about how comparing. And so now, let's talk about complaining. According to Webster's Dictionary, complaining is to express dissatisfaction or annoyance about a state of affairs or an event. We do it all the time. Every human does this. We complain. It's like a default. The put out state. When we focus on lack, when we focus on dissatisfaction, we manifest that. That is how incredible we are. We compound it, we magnify it, we expand it. All we're saying is, so be it. And through it all, the nerves take hold, the body shakes, rumbles, crumbles. Anxiety takes hold because we're complaining. We run around with our mind solely focused on lack. Complaining is nothing more than not trusting God. Not trusting that we are taken care of. Duality. Run amok. Everything is divine. We are always protected. So what can we do when we're complaining? When we don't believe that things are going to be okay? When we don't embrace just how amazing this dream really is. The purpose of life is to be beautiful, to be bountiful, to be graceful, and to be grateful. When one is great and full, one is God. Whatever smallness we face, greet it with being great. Full of that greatness. Yogi Bhajan has highlighted, it is good to say, hello, how are you? Good morning, my creator. Thank you very much. It is called gratitude. The attitude of gratitude brings you opportunities beyond your concept. And when the prayer becomes the vibration of the soul, the mind, and the self, we can create a miracle. But if we hold on to complaint, if we decide to just hold on, right? Holding on to the duality, the separation, it will only bring misery. It is. So how do we deal with this? Right? Gratitude. Compliment yourself. Be grateful, full of being great. You guys, this is a dream. It's not even real, man. It's not even real. Oh my God, but no, insert anger, insert, you know, doubt, fear, being scared. Insert duality. Oh yes, we need to feel it. We need to feel how alive we really are. And you know what? I'm choosing to manifest through feeling it, through all this pain and suffering and fear. Enjoy. You are listening to The Master's Playground. My name is Chrissy Stereo. And tonight we are looking at comparing, competing, and complaining. I am. Everybody does it. But it's so important to hone in on women. On this one. We have more receptors. We have more facets. 16 times more than a male. That is how much more intuitive we are. Because of that, it makes us more sensitive. We have a great responsibility of maintaining grace, setting the tone. So let's take a look at competing. According to Webster's Dictionary, it is to strive. Okay, its meaning is strive to gain or win something by defeating or establishing superiority over others who are trying to do the same. It also means to take part in a contest. Amazing what separating one's own self from their divine grace can result in. Competition. The only thing that could be won is your own self. That's it. Nothing else is real. Again, see the God in all. Randomsong.com. Yes, thank you. All right, you guys, you have been listening to The Master's Playground. My name is Chrissy Stereo, and tonight we've been looking at the three enemies that a woman could have. Now, remember, for the guys that are tuning in, and, you know, I see you guys. It's great. So, remember, what your contribution is, right? What you can do to, you know, is stay steady and support the female. Why? Because she is more sensitive. She is more receptive. She is more, she's getting more information. And you are the steady support. At least according to yogic tradition. So recap. What to do if you're comparing yourself to another? How about saying, I am enough? If you're complaining about the events and the play-by-play of your life, embrace the attitude of gratitude. And lastly, if you're competing in your own world, man, you're looking at another person, they're doing something similar, what have you, and you find yourself in a competitive mode, there is no competition. Because the only winning that can be had in this life is to win your own self. There's a friend of mine who said something really cute. I pity the fool who tries to beat me at being me. Yeah. All right, you guys, we're going to end the show with looking at the Kabbalah Tarot for the coming week. Yes, it is traditional here on the Master's Playground for us to ask Spirit. Spirit, what are the energies that we can anticipate for the coming week? We ended up getting the Emperor. Beautiful card. We are going to be greeted with the energies of where we have consideration for others. It's also a symbol of the wisdom that we have gained from our own challenges. And it's allowing us to push forward into our success. It literally is highlighting that we're coming out of a shell of disorganized thought to gain serenity. So I'd like to compliment it with, how do we navigate? How do we navigate those energies this coming week, you guys? Well, with that, Spirit presented the Eight of Cups. Okay, so with the Eight of Cups, this is such a beautiful, incredibly sacred card. Well, they all are. But this one, if you look at the character on the Eight of Cups tarot card, it is an individual who is walking away from all that they thought they wanted and going in deeper into their spiritual work. It means that they've let go of the tendency of holding on to the past. And dive in further into their soul, into their spirit. Authenticity. Yes. And lastly, you guys, I'd like to ask, what is the gift / challenge for the week? And we were presented with the Lover's card. First keyword, trust. The challenge slash gift for the coming week is to embrace more trust while maintaining an expectation for ourselves as well. The challenge slash gift for the coming week is establishing balance and conception while maintaining harmony. The lovers, to see everyone as the divine. The challenge is to embrace our God selves so that we can open up to that frequency. So I think it's going to be an amazing week. Yes. Fabulous. Now, you guys, I have an announcement to make. All right. So as you know, I've been on the psychic tour and I've been, one busy girl. I will not be on air next week. I'm taking next week off because I am moving. Spirit is guiding me to a new chapter of my life now. I will be back. So look for more information on triplegoddesspro.me, chrissystereo.com, Facebook, Chrissy Stereo. It's all beautiful, you guys. It's all opening up. The new chapter, the new beginning. A new mission. Thank you so much for tuning in. You are listening to The Master's Playground. My name is Chrissy Stereo, and it is an honor and a true gift to live this life in service. May this show continue to inspire you. May this show continue to illuminate all of us. With that, a prayer. May the longtime sun shine upon you. All love surround you. And the pure light within you guide your way on. Blessings. I love you. Bye.
Love yourself. Love yourself. 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 Love each other.
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 We are one.
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 We are
the divine,
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 the divine, the divine.
Blessings,
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 blessings.
The Master's Playground.
The Master's Playground.